Hi, welcome to Enchiridion. Greererpeton, burkemorani, was a colosteid-stemmed tetrapod from the Early Carboniferous period of North America. It was first described by famed vertebrate paleontologist Alfred S. Romer in 1969. Colosteids have been placed with the temnospondyls in some classifications, and with the anthracosaurs in the others, yet the skull is different from most members of that group. Despite the fact that Greererpeton evolved amongst the first land-living temnospondyls, it didn't follow the other tetrapods on a land, rather it reverted to a completely aquatic life. Its low, flat head was about a little more than a half a foot long, at 7 inches or 18 centimeters in length. The most complete adult specimen only preserved 12 tail vertebrae, about one-third the length of the body as in Andrias. Nonetheless, smaller specimens have been discovered preserving around 30 vertebrae, so it isn't completely inconceivable that a complete tail was approximately as long as the body. The limbs were rather short, yet not vestigial. The fingers were still well developed. Young Andrias congregate in shallow water, while older individuals were bottom-dwelling predators, preferring deeper waters. Given the fact that small Greererpeton skeletons have been discovered in groups while larger ones are solitary, it is presumable that Greererpeton behaved similarly. Its slim body plan would have been perfect for moving through water with sinuous undulations. Its body was extended and had twice the usual number of vertebrae, at around 40, and ended in a long tail. The body may have been flattened from top to bottom or dorsoventrally, while the tail was flattened from side to side or medial laterally, into a fin-like appendage used for swimming. Its legs were short, each with 5 toes for braking and steering. The open grooves along the sides of its skull indicate that it had fish ancestry. They mark the location of sensory lateral land canals, which were used to detect vibrations originating from water. Unlike that of land-living amphibians or terrestrial animals, Greererpeton's ear structure was poorly developed. This, along with evidence of a lateral line, a sensory apparatus found in fish, reduced limbs and an extended spine, giving it a more eel-like appearance, suggested it adapted to an aquatic lifestyle. This indicates that there was a plethora of prey to be found in the waters of the early Carboniferous, and that Greererpeton had specialized in hunting them. It retains a postbranchial lamina on its shoulder blade, which may have been indicative of internal gills like those of fish, yet the erratic distribution of postbranchial laminae in aquatic and terrestrial fish and amphibians makes this conclusion questionable. Greererpeton means creeper from Greer or crawler from Greer, West Virginia. It was named by Romer in 1969. Species include G. burkemorani. It was a carnivore that probably lived in rivers and swamps. It was up to 5 feet or 1.5 meters in total length, similar in size to Andrias, modern Asian giant salamanders, which could grow up to 4.9 feet, also 1.5 meters in length. The body was elongated with about 40 vertebrae. It was discovered in West Virginia, Illinois, and North America. It lived during the late Bichon of the early Carboniferous, and fossil representation includes numerous specimens displaying variations in size and age in diverse stages of development. And with that, thank you for watching this program episode of Prehistoric Beasts as a short fact-based episode. I will soon be editing a video compilation of all the early tetrapods and amphibians mentioned in previous videos for a documentary-style compilation. This is Enchiridion. See you next time.